Hi, welcome to Can of Spader Christmas. In this episode, I wanted to perform a little experiment. The generator that I have, the little Honda generator, wanted to hook a load up to that and run it and see how long it would run for. It's supposed to run for about 8 hours. So I was trying to figure out, okay, what kind of load could I use? I don't have a space heater. Now, for the load, like I said, I got some of these heat lamps. I got 6 of these, and so I got 5 of these heat lamps, so it should be 1,250 watts. As you'll see, they did a pretty good job. They're used, you know, for keeping food warm and things like that. It's just an infrared light. You put them in the bathroom to heat it up, that kind of thing. So I decided to get a number of those. I would kind of equal what a space heater would be, because that's probably also the upper range of what the load should be for this generator. So, and then it's also something that I could duplicate once I get the power wall built, and then we can kind of compare numbers and see how close I got to coming up to about half of it. So here's the experiment. It was kind of fun, and I learned some things. So here's what happened. So we're currently pulling 0 watts. We'll turn the first one on. That's 258 watts at 2.12 amps. 257. Second light. 511 watts. 4.24 amps. Third one. 760 watts. 6.34 amps. Thousand watts. 8.39 amps. 1,242 watts at 10.45 amps. What I was trying to tell you was that after the lights had been on for a little while, I felt the extension cord and there was no heat at all in the extension cord, so that was not a problem. The generator does make a lot of noise, even though it is a quiet generator. And the exhaust coming out of the generator is pretty stinky.
It just shut off at about 3:45.
Yeah. So the first, I was gonna split it up in 4 hour increments, or at least 4 hours for the first day, and then however long it would run the second day, probably about 4 hours it should have. But it didn't. It quit at 3:45 the first day, and the second day it would not run more than about a minute. So I have some kind of fuel issue. I don't know. I don't think it's the carburetor, because I only run that the True Fuel in there. Not a sponsor, but if you want to, let me know. So it doesn't have ethanol in it, and I don't think it has all that other gunk that turns to varnish, but I don't know. I'll have to get into the carburetor to check it out. Could also be a fuel filter problem. Again, that's going to take some maintenance, so I'm going to have to tear the generator apart and take a look at it to figure out what's going on. to continue that experiment. But I still have the load. So I'm processing batteries right now. There's a ton of videos out there about doing that. I mean, basically popping cells in the chargers, letting them charge, discharge, and recharge, noting the or sorting them into different piles of capacity. And then you can, you know, basically follow that flow chart that Daniel has on his website. The weekend was not a total loss, however. I did discover that my wife very much dislikes the generator running. Now, granted, there was no power problem, and she was outside while the generator was running, so I totally understand her not liking the generator. But, and if we were out of power, totally different situation. But I just found that humorous that she didn't like it running even for the 3 hours and 45 minute test that ran. Now, yes, I do realize that the load that I built is extremely dangerous, especially if you have children that like to touch things and, you know, animals that can get up near the lights. You don't want that. Those lights do get hot. And if you are in that situation, then build a cage for it. I had it up high so the dogs weren't going to get to it, and that was my only concern. It did get kind of toasty in here, so it was really kind of nice. It wasn't hot. If you have any questions, leave them below. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.